Well, I decided to come back to this area and see what it's all about. Look at this. Dead bird. Wonder if you land on one of the power lines up there and fried. That would suck. Oh yeah, I'm gonna land on this power line. That really would suck. See power lines up there? If you wanna go fishing, just throw your fishing line over that. You might catch a, electric eel or something. Yeah, I'm gonna come back and I'm gonna see if I can go that way to get to the bayou faster and see if I can go up a little bit this way and see if there's a trail nearby. And I better check for ticks when I get home. See what ticks do. They crawl up to the highest point and they put their little arms out. When you walk by, they catch into your fur, if you have any, or your clothes. And they go in and bite you and suck your blood. You know, this is Halloween, so they could do that. All right, take a look at this. Oh, I hate to be a bug out here. Look at all those damn thinking. All right, a fly lands here and he slips in. He goes into the belly of this creature and you'll be solely devoured. First you probably drown, you know, all the liquids in there. Then you would digest your body. Don't hurt me. You know, I scare myself sometimes. Don't hurt me. Mama, hurry! I hope y'all enjoying this little trip I'm taking for my friend Donnie Panellini. Donnie Panellini. Looks like the bayou right there. I think I went too far, so I traveled back to see where this bayou is. If it's right here by these trees. See, I got that tree line right there. One of two things. The guy didn't want to cut it, or there's something there that we need to explore. Man, this is hell, man, going through this. Oh, crap. Alright, looks like we're getting close to something out here. We're not close at all. There we go. Yeah, it's a little soggy out here. So that means one of two things. Natural spring out here. Or rain recently, which I... No, it can't be rain. It's kind of soggy. So water runs through this area. Good source of water if you need it. You know, dig a hole. And take a cup. Scoop out water. Get your thirst busted. All right, let's see a few minutes. This video's getting too long. All right, what the hell? Yep, there's the ditch. See, I'm always right about this stuff. You know, they didn't want to cut this because look, it's soggy. They don't want to get their tractor stuck. Like a little fit, it's like a coon washing his meal. We're catching cake crayfish. I hope I don't slip. Yeah, I'm not going no further. All right, I'm going to do more research. Come back out here for Donnie Panellini. I hope you enjoyed this video. All right, see you next video. Well, I hear some deer over here. See if I can sneak up and see their asses. Could be a squirrel too. All right, looks like I found a better place for Donnie's camping, new camping hole. What you think, Donnie?
Look how beautiful and open this area is. Imagine all the bushcrafting stuff you could do out here. Looks like we're getting closer to the bayou. Look at that.
Alright, see you in a few seconds. Look, a stump that you can use. Man, imagine what you can do out here. Holy crap. And this is not a big park either. It's just a little bitty bicycle trail. And I don't think anybody will mess with you out here. That was a snake. Alright, see you in a few seconds. Well, I'm Ranger Kooky, and this video is for Donnie Paolini. I finally made it to the bayou. Bam! Now, I do believe this is a very beautiful place to put a camp. You got bayou water. This would be like a bug out place. Or somewhere just to get away from everybody. I'll pick this place if I had to. Let's take a look. Well, you got some good trees for hammocks. You got good camping ground for tents. There's a trail right there. Good for backpacking. I didn't see no signs that you can't come out back here to backpack or camp. So let's take a look a little further before we start heading back. And I'm going to show Donnie Paolini that the bayou is right here. Oh, look at this. Nice little private beach down there. Oh man, look at that. Let's take a trip down the main. See, camping site up the road. You can camp up here. We'll camp down here. Recommend to make a good trail to the bayou. Look at this. Oh, look at the fishies. Oh man, you come out here and swim. Get some driftwood. Look at all that driftwood out there. Not good pieces, but they got some good pieces out here. If you're doing the summer, you can walk through that water. Well, what y'all see out there? Y'all see anything good? All right, come back over here. Come over here. All right. Well, Donnie, I found you a new camping space that you didn't have time to go do. I did it for you because I love to do the recon, but now we have to walk up that treacherous freaking thing. See, if I had my machete, I could make steps so it'd be easy to get back up. But a little rope and a little machete, I think we can get back up this hill. No problem. Look at that. Hey, whoa, mama. Whew, that took a lot out of me. All right, let's go up a couple more feet. Take a look down. Another little beach. Looks like it's easy to get to the water. Damn it. Out of breath.
All right, look at that.
All right, I'm gonna take the video camera, go all the way to where you can park your vehicle, since you have a truck. You can go all the way to that bridge. Now this would be a bug out place, just to get away from danger, if any. There'll be no zombies out here, because when the zombie apocalypse attack, or the aliens, you don't want to be near civilization. All right, hey, watch the woods. Enjoy the trail that I'm in. A little private beach down that way. No, camping area. And I want to say to my subscribers, please go over and check out Mike, the Lone Wolf. I'm going to repeat myself. Go check out Mike, Lone Wolf. I'm over there on his channel, teaching them how to survive and the 75 C's and 11 C's. So go over there and check him out. I'm teaching him how to survive. So go over there and take a look. He's interesting to watch. Especially when his lost video, he got lost in by the beautiful triangle in my woods. So I'm trying to teach him how to navigate through the woods and stuff like that. And it's fun to watch. So go over there and check out Mike Lone Wolf. All right, take a look at this, Donnie. This video is for you. This is a dedication video for you. Since you didn't have time to recon a new camping area, I did it for you, my friend. I love recon. Recon's fun. Like I said, it gets me out the house. And gets me in the woods like I like to be. And it's getting colder now. I can come out here and enjoy the woods instead of being I'm tired of thirst. So it's comfortable right now. It's still 80. Humid, about maybe 60 maybe. I'm taking a wild guess. I'm not no damn weatherman, but I'm trying. But here you go, Donnie. I want to show you the bayou I was telling you about. And the little places you can camp. And a little path to get to that camping area if you want to. It's a little hike, I'm telling you. I love these hikes. This is what camping and surviving is all about. Hikes. Walking in through the woods. Find a good camping space and pinch up camp. Yeah, it's back to Mike Lone Wolf channel. I'm over there teaching them how to survive. I gave them a lot of gear so they can go camping. I gave them all kinds of the 5 C's and some other little knickknacks that he wanted, so I gave it to him. He is fun to watch, I'm telling you. You need to go over there to Mike Lone Wolf channel. Check him out. Darn it. And this is a video for Donnie Palalini. And I'm ready to go do your tag that you tagged me. Damn you, Donnie. How dare you tag me? Believe it or not, I love tags. I like when people tag me. I've been tagged twice so far. I took up a challenge, which was Bob 808 Knight. I took his challenge or tag. Because I like this. Two types of tags I'll take. If I like a tag that somebody says, I'm tagging you, my subscribers. And if it's a nice one, I'll do it. If I see it. Then I got the other tag, which I'm tagging you, Ranger Cookie. I'm tagging you, Donnie, or Landman, or Mike Long Wolf, or whoever I tag. Or somebody tags me, I'll take up that tag. That's about it. just want you to enjoy the woods, Donnie. Look that way, damn you, boy!
Here's another big camping spot. A lot of wood. Look at this area, man. Big, open area. And I'm gonna take a shortcut. First, we'll get rid of these damn picking irons on my feet. I wish I could find some better pants and better shirts and thinner. Oh well. Alright. Take a look. Sorry, I'm going a little too fast. Oh well. Life's a bitch. Look at the campsite here, man. Imagine about 100 people in tents and hammocks in this location. Trash. Damn them people. It looks like a good Ziploc bag, but I don't know what's been in it. Might be marijuana. And by the way, when you're in the woods and you see a little piece of paper, pick it up. It's light. It's a Ziploc bag. It looks like a heavy-duty Ziploc bag. But pick up some trash on your way out. I'm on my way out, so I picked it up. That way, Donnie. Look forward. Look at that. So I got a shout out to the Long Wolf, Mike the Long Wolf, and Donnie Paolini. Also, I'm showing you this video just to show you how far you might have to walk if you have, you know, you have your bag with you. If you do camp, come out here to camp or just do a little bushcrafting. I'd love to see you come out here, Mr. Donnie, and do some bushcrafting, because I'll see you. I'll love to see what you could do out here. It looks like a safe place to park your truck up here by this bridge we're coming up to, and walk from here to the bayou, which is not that far of a walk. But here you go, Donnie. I hope you enjoy this crazy video I made for you. I'm doing recon for Donnie Paolini. It took me 12 minutes to walk to where your car can be parked. See, here's a bridge. It means your truck has to be parked on this side of the bridge. Right there. And you can walk 12 minutes to that area. That's not far. 12 minutes is not far, but I have to walk from here to the car, and that's pretty far. All right, Donnie, I hope you enjoyed this video. Like I said, it's a bike trail, and there was a car back here already, so you can't say, oh no, I can't go back there, but there was a truck back here already. You means you can get your truck back here too. I want to see you do some work out here in this area, maybe some fishing or build you a little fish trap or something. And don't forget, boys and girls, to eat it every day. Wait a minute. That's Walton and Johnson. That's my heroes. I'm a 2%er. I don't have enough more to say.
I just hope y'all take care. Flint and steel. Look, if you watch this video, I hope you take care of that finger of yours. I seen the duct tape all over your finger. Ooh, that's sharp. That knife was sharp. This one's sharp too. Kind of scared to even use the damn thing. And it just makes me wonder about the community out here. The community of YouTube. I put challenges out and no one takes the challenge. Three people answer some of my challenge I have on my channel for my 200 subscribers. Makes me wonder, why are y'all not, don't want to do nothing for me? I remember tagging a few people and they never did the tags. That kind of bums me out. Alright, I'm going to end this video with Donnie. I'll make another bum out video about what YouTube bums me out of. Stay tuned to the next video. It might be a month from now. I'm going to print that baby up. Because I do a lot of videos. Put it on my channel. Lock it so you can't see it. Private. And when I get so many views of my other videos, I put one out. And this is much the most treacherous spot that you have to go through, Donnie. But you see there's another truck here. Went through it. I'm in a car. I don't think the car will make it through this. So the truck definitely can make it through that. I'm surprised he went through that. Oh well. Yeah, this is supposed to be a Donnie video. And the Mike Longwolf and Flint and Steel. I hope you take care of that big finger of yours. Yeah, I watched a video of Flint and Steel. I think I'm saying his name right wrong again. But he cut his finger doing some work. And cut his finger pretty bad. See tape all over his hand. Take care there, buddy. David, that's your name. If I'm not mistaken. I think it's David. I had to photograph them. Some of the comments in there. And I see David. Alright, Dave. Hope you take care and get back out in the woods. I like your videos. Alright, like I said, this is a video for Donnie Paolini showing you your new campsite. Mike Lone Wolf. Go check him out. He's funny to watch. He got lost in the woods. The 75 C's and other things I've been teaching them. And Flint and Steel. Be careful, my friend. Your knife is sharp. Hope you get better and hope you see you back in the great woods. Because I think you're right. I'm glad you don't do, hey, this is a knife. Look at it, it's a knife. I'm glad you don't do gear reviews. But right now you might have to because your finger. He's also right about that. People doing backyard reviews of their equipment. That's a bummer. That's part of my bummer video. It's going to be next. Why YouTube bums me out. Or why YouTube bums me. You know, I get aggravated sometimes. Very aggravated. But it's not my fault. Enough of that. This is about Donnie. Alright, I'm going to go ahead and end this video. Because I don't have far to my car. And you got a bunch of bike trails. But I'll think if you was camping out there, I don't think no one will mess with your vehicle or mess with your gear. Alright, I'll see you later on Ranger Cookie Hill.